Game week 7 was another fairly bad game week, and more bad decisions with regards to my transfer strategy, which seems to have been rash up until now. Once again, Emi Martinez disappointed us at Aston Villa in terms of their backline, conceding 4 goals in their loss to Southampton, making my goalkeeper essentially useless in the squad. Bringing in Chilwell for Trent seems to have worked out, as Chelsea's defensive woes looks like they've gotten a little bit better, with the great form of new goalkeeper Mendy, while the other two defenders didn't fare so well in the team. Son coming in for Grealish backfired, as he didn't bring in any returns, while Grealish secured 15 points for those who owned him. Harrison's assist means he and Salah were the only midfielders who brought in returns, while Calvert-Lewin continued his impressive start for Everton with another goal. Harry Kane, who was this week's captain, scored once again to help Spurs get past Brighton in a narrow 2-1 victory, which also saw Gareth Bale score his first goal for the club since his return. Despite a final score of 49 points, 4 were subtracted due to the transfer, and I finished the game week with 45 points and a total score of 420, bringing my rank to just about 500,000. With Antonio being injured, I've decided to use my free transfer to take him out of the squad and bring in Callum Wilson. He's currently the third highest scoring forward in FPL and has only banked in 2 out of 7 game weeks so far. He's also well priced at only 6.5. Wilson also happens to be Newcastle's penalty taker and has scored 3 of them this season so far. Along with his good form, he also has decent fixtures going up against Palace, Villa and Southampton in the next 5. Emi stays in the squad as Arsenal take on Aston Villa and the rest of the defence goes unchanged. Chilwell is self-explanatory, but Walker Peters and Justin worry me, with their opponents being Newcastle and Wolves, but they are the best options available in the team at the moment. Clich makes his way from the midfield to the bench, while the rest of the midfield stays the same. Harrison has been impressive so far, and Leeds have made it a habit of bouncing back after a loss and come out stronger, with Bielsa learning as he goes in the Premier League. Bruno scored against Everton last season, and without Richarlison and James, they don't seem as dangerous as when they started, and so I'm expecting a result from Manchester United, with Fernandes spearheading the attack. I was more confident earlier on in the week, but Manchester United did lose their midweek Champions League tie, which makes me wonder if they're on the best form. Salah and Son have both been on fine form, and their positions in the team's locked. Wilson makes his debut in my squad, while on-form Dominic Calvert-Lewin and Harry Kane complete the squad, with the latter retaining the armband for another week. Go ahead and leave your own fantasy tips in the comments below, and be sure to like the video if you did, subscribe to the channel for more Premier League content, and hit the bell notification icon so you know when the next video is released.